Everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel again. It's your girl again, Peshwari. In case you're new, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment. So, in today's video, I visited this old grandma. She's 100 plus years old. Grandma, she is also very poor, she can't see clearly. So, I met her at the farm where she was trying to collect some banana leaves, which she wants to use as firewood. She told me for the last 2 days she hasn't eaten anything. She has not eaten anything. I felt sorry for her. I felt very bad. This old grandma, as you can see her, she doesn't have food. She doesn't have anyone to look after her. She doesn't have anything even to cook. She can't even go to work. She can't even see straight. So, it's actually very bad. It's actually very, very bad for her that she's poor, no one to visit, no one to take care of her. So she told me for the last 2 days she hasn't eaten anything, and so that's why she was trying to collect some banana leaves and see if she can put them to the fire. But she didn't have anything to cook. She just prepared them. If anyone comes along with something, she can get some like firewood. She wanted to use this place as firewood because she doesn't have even firewood to cook. But she told me if she gets something to cook, she can really try. She keep on she tries very much to cook so that she won't die of hunger. As you can see, she's even shaking. She can't walk straight. She can't even. She's very old, as you can see. 100 plus years is just a joke. So, this is her life, as you can see her. And this is what she was trying to correct and use as firewood. It isn't easy actually to cook with this thing because it's not easy to use this thing. You can see right now she is trying to put them right so that they can dry off because they are very wet. Because right now at my country we have a rainy season. It's rainy season. So it isn't easy for her. You can see she's shaking a lot. So this is her life. You can imagine being this old and poor, being this old and not have anyone to help you, being this old and nothing even to eat or cook. So as you can see, I told you she can't see straight. So that clothes she was wearing, and as you can see, she put it down the floor to dry off. That's how she put it to dry off, just down the floor. This is how this old grandma walks. She uses a walking stick to walk so that she can't fall because she is very weak and very old, and also weak even more because of hunger. She told me she can even finish 3 days to 4 days without eating something. It's only by grace if someone passes by and give her something to eat. So as you can see, she is trying to get inside the house. That's how she walks around her house. It's actually a big trouble for her. It's really hard for her even to walk, even to get inside her own house. This old grandma over here, she told me she doesn't, as you can see, she doesn't have any electricity, and she can't even find any paraffin for the soul or a candle to use at night. So she just try walk inside the house, and being very dark, it is very, very not okay for her. As you can see, this is how much she struggles when she wants to get inside and cook something. So this is where she sits when she wants to try and cook something. This is how she does it. You can see. Now she wants to put on fire and cook some tea, because she told me she hasn't eaten anything. And because I had come with some milk, I wanted to see how she cooks, because you can imagine this old trying to cook for herself. It's even a very big risk for her even to have a fire up inside the house, because as you can see, she can't even see it. She just sees some beans. As you can see. So I asked her to get outside so that I can cook for her. I asked her to come outside so that I can cook tea for her, and take it before I could cook lunch for her, because it isn't an easy thing for this old grandma to stay without food. So I came with some shopping for her, and she was very happy. You can see she is touching and dressing me. Everything I remove, she touches, and she can tell me what is it. That's a pork, a cornflour. There is rice, there is sugar, there is cooking oil, there is cabbage, there is tea leaves. So she could touch and tell me what is it by just touching. But before then, I have surprise for my grandma over here. I told her to touch and tell me what the surprise was, but she couldn't guess light. She told me she doesn't know what this is. So I want to surprise her right now. My viewers just watch me surprising my old grandma over here. And you will see how happy she was. Just wait for Rick. Oh my god, grandma was happy. She enjoyed after knowing that I brought a radio for her. She told me she really loved radio, just to listen and feel like she has someone with her over here. You can see she's singing. She's breathing me. She's singing Catholic songs. She told me she's a Catholic, and she wants me to put a station called Maria for her so that she could listen about Catholic teaching. She was very happy she breathed me. So right now I'm teaching her how to put it on and off. And you couldn't guess how happy this was. She was very happy. I felt it. I felt good that I did something that made her happy for today. But before I could leave, I bought her some firewood because I could see she was going through a lot without firewood. So this firewood, I just bought them. And the boda bring it here. So I'm trying to pack it inside the house and put it safe inside the house because it's rainy season. And I was very happy because at least I fulfilled one request from grandma to bring her a radio because she told me she get bored. You can imagine all day 24/7 living alone, staying alone. You can't go anywhere because she can't see, she can't even walk. But with her having a radio, she'll feel much, she'll be very, she won't be bored.